let's just take circa 2007. Right? My brother won. That's great. Awesome. But the testing involved was for that then and for the time of what CrossFit was then, what fitness, I guess, is then, was based on a lot of well-roundedness, is what I would call it, because he had to do everything. The first, there were two events that were known, and one event that was going to be a middle time frame event. There was a max effort. There was a powerlifting meet, basically, squat, deadlift, press, and you could do a 5K run. So that's the exact example I gave earlier, right? If you finish first over here, you should not be finishing first on that one. If you did, it's because there was not many people in the competition, which actually happened. But like, for example, Spieler won the run, and he came nowhere close to winning that event. When my brother finished second in the run, he finished middle of the pack in that. So he finished, that was the best. He did the best on that. And then in the middle, they had like a row, chin-up, whatever one's like a, and then that timing of like 10 to 12 minutes of really high effort movement. So at that time, you look at it and go, wow, that's cool. But then as things move on, and you get down to like, okay, 2011, 2012, now we're 2012, and no one believes, or I would say a very large majority, no one believes you need to be good at running anymore. Because the goal for the large majority get to the games, to get there. It's not to do well at the games. For most people, I would argue, it's I want to get there. When I'm there, whatever, let's get it done, who cares? And I'm sure that's not the actual attitude of most people, but suffice to say is that as the testing changes over the years, the training changes, okay? So let's just say, for example, we live in a different world, and last year's regionals, we changed it out, and it wasn't handstand pushes with deadlifts. It was deadlifts and burpees for the first event. Okay, and the next event actually was a kettlebell swing into pistols into rowing, not the other way. And the next event was touch-and-go power snatches and little shuttle runs. And the next event was, like, cindy, we'll call it. We'll just call it cindy. That's what we're going to do instead of that other event. And then we have a one-rep max snatch. And then the next event involves like light deadlifts and push-ups. So just imagine that's what it was. How does that then dictate who's going to be the winner? And then how does that dictate how you're going to train differently for the next year, knowing that that's what you were tested on? You know how that's going to change everything. You're going to be like, okay, I need to be lighter. I need to be more enduring. I have to have way better lungs. And I have to be able to do this. What about muscle-ups? Yeah, well, they're in there, but they're not the main issue for me, because like no one else can really move them. Versus everybody's kind of like on the strength path, being like this is the most important end all be all. And so as the testing has changed over the years, it has determined the training methods. Right? So if you ask the best coaches or whatever in 2010 how they were training people for the games, if you go to 2013 and 2020, you want to see what the methods are. That the methods are going to change based on what the testing is, right? Which just bears to me the sport is changing, you're trying to figure things out. That's okay, that's young, that's going to happen. But to change the amount that it has is kind of odd, okay? Because like I said earlier, because of the new testing standards, as the law goes into the competitions, and we'll use the females again, every female, to large and well, most of them, their number one goals are snatch, clean and jerk, muscle ups, handstand push ups, chest bar chin ups. Right? That, and like, that's what I think, from what I see in females, the large majority of them that are not the top level competitors, that is their number one goal. Because they don't have those movements. And that's what they're going, okay, I gotta get these in order to be able to compete. But that only occurred based on the testing change. Like, I gotta be able to do 30 muscle ups in a workout, or 20 or 30 or 21 handstand push ups, or I'm out. You're done. That's the way it goes. Same thing for males. It's like, my whatever run time, row time, I can maintain that, or whatever. I don't really care. As long as like my clean jerk goes up, and what I can do for a 5 rep max snatch goes up, and what I can do for that's the problem, that you can design the testing, and like I said earlier, if you can like get the competition down to like 2 parts, then what were the other 8 parts for? What were the other 8 parts for? Why did you do it? It was just kind of hangout time, in my opinion, right? Like, outside of the fact that, yes, there was camaraderie, yes, you were competing with your buds. You could have did 2 events and went home, because the winner was decided after that. Based on those, you can just sum it up in 2 events, which I think you have to decipher things and change them, and then go, yep,